Dan here from Math for Love, and I'm here to talk about multiplication. This is going to be a two-part video series. Today, just single-digit multiplication. So I want to start with a very simple question, which is, what do I mean when I say, what is 3 times 8? From one perspective, once I understand that multiplication itself means 3 groups of 8, 3 times 8 is just 3 groups of 8, I kind of have a good answer, right? 3 groups of 8. There it is. I've built it. This is 1 group of 8, 2 groups of 8, 3 groups of 8. That's kind of enough sometimes. But what we usually mean when we're asking for an answer or to know the fact is to know how to express 3 groups of 8 in base 10. It's useful to translate things into a common language, which is how we use base 10. We have a bias towards it because we have 10 fingers. There we go. We've gotten used to it. But when you have multiple perspectives, like, oh, I have 3 groups of 8 and I want to compare that to 5 groups of 5, which one's bigger? It's tricky to know the answer to that when those are kind of in their different groupings in different languages. It's easier if you say, well, that's 2 groups of 10 and 4 more. This is 2 groups of 10 and 5 more. Much easier to compare, also easier to add, subtract, multiply, and divide them when we get to that. So the fundamental thing you need to know about one-digit multiplication, and when we want a model of this, is we can actually build this or draw it as 3 groups of 8, and then we can solve it in this sense, by which I mean translate it into base 10, just by changing the grouping sizes, just by rearranging our blocks or grouping our dots or whatever we're doing, so we have groups of 10, in this case 2 groups of 10, and 4 extra ones. That is the project of one-digit multiplication, is understanding that we're taking some number of groups and then rearranging the groups so we have groups of 10 with extra ones. That's all it is. The rest is just getting fluent enough with that, getting straight with that, so that we can do it quickly and kind of understand how that translation goes back and forth. A very useful model for this is the array, that rectangular grid. Just takes some of the load off of our mind and makes it easier to see and remember what's going on. So I recommend arranging things in groups that have a powerful structure to them. The array is just one of the most powerful and useful ones that we have. Also useful can be a 100 chart, where we actually can track what's happening as we add 8 and 8 and 8 more. 1 8, 2 8, 3 8 gets us to 24. The tens are baked into this also, because each row has 10 in it. Different models are useful. The most important thing is just that you use some model or visual that is meaningful to you, that helps you begin this from a place of understanding. And what you'll find is the actual memorization part becomes much, much easier, much more quick when we understand what we're doing, understand that we're taking 3 groups of 8, rearranging them into groups of 10 with extras. So I'll talk about how to extend this into multi-digit multiplication later. Until then.